Well, good morning, all you happy people. It's 3 o'clock on Sunday afternoon, Saturday afternoon, the 24th of July. We went to the clinic this morning about 7:30 a.m. Got a friend to drive us over there, and it was a different kind of an experience having this surgery on my cheek. And you can see I've got a nice bandage over here. But there were three doctors and a nurse, and they put me to sleep kind of slowly with the anesthetic and this hand. Nevertheless, I drowsed off, kind of mumbling and unable to think, and I think it still has effect because I feel rather tongue-tied. At any rate, about 3 hours or so later, I undrowsed a little bit enough to realize that I was still alive, and Margarita was in the room with me, and you know, I wasn't feeling any pain, so that felt good. I touched the bandage to see how big a space it covered and to make sure that it was going to stay there. The doctors had disappeared. The nurse came in every once in a while. One of the doctors came back in and kept poking me, "Roger, Roger, you know, wake up," in Spanish, of course. I didn't really feel like waking up, and I was starting to resent being poked. I was enjoying my sleep, and I don't know if they rent the room by the hour, you know, kind of like a recording studio. You know, after a while, Margarita said she had called the friend to come back, that I was done. He sent his girlfriend, and that was okay. She had air conditioning in her car as well. You know, after a while, they took the robe off me. I don't know why they made me take my shirt off. I had everything else on, and booties. So I got dressed, I stood up, and I didn't feel anything, you know, to make me want to feel I'm going to fall over. So that was good. So we went to the door and waited for the friend to come. Now, something that you probably are used to is GPS. While we were riding to Santa Ana, to the clinic, my friend, the driver, was talking to his GPS person. I don't know if it's Siri or one of these other people. But I had a copy of a map and the direction written on top of the paper, which we gave him to get his bearings. We did ride around the neighborhood a few times. I was pretty sure I knew how to get there by reading maps. I'm a Boy Scout, you know, an Eagle Scout at that. We finally got there, and not everybody was there because people in El Salvador are remarkably unpunctual. But it was interesting to listen to him listening to this voice and driving based on what she's saying, that she knows exactly where we are. It's our second biggest city in the country, Santa Ana. And Google Maps pretty much have all the streets marked out. You know, in the urban part of it, it's largely urban, but there's very much rural that's part of the city of Santa Ana. So, but it was fun for me to watch this modern thing. I mean, I don't have it on my bicycle. There's something on my smartphone, but my smartphone is too smart for me, so I don't even bother about it. We have to go back to the doctor that did the surgery, the actual surgery, I guess, the plastic surgeon, and on Tuesday. So, you know, we'll be able to take the bus and get there, you know, sanely. So I'm looking forward to it, but the only instructions he gave to Margarita was I shouldn't go out and do, you know, hard things or do anything that might strain the stitches. that are in the cheek at this time. So, I joked with them. I told them I expected to look like Antonio Banderas when I get the bandage taken off. I was going to use Brad Pitt, but he's old and can't even get a decent divorce in custody. The problem settled. I'm an expert at that. So I just want to let you all know I'm fine, looking good. There's never any guarantee to anything when it comes to cancer, but they insisted that they got everything that they needed to get out. So God bless everybody. As God has blessed me. I thank all of you for your prayers, your letters, emails, Facebook comments, whatever it was. We're both thankful that I'm okay, and our next challenge is on the 30th when Margarita goes to the hospital in Huachapan to check her breast out, make sure she doesn't have anything going on inside her. So once again, love you all. Thanks a million.